can Liquid really make it work in this day and age? Mikke on the Sven. Really keeping the pressure on this top lane very early. 2 minutes in, Liquid starting to dive beyond the tower, getting aggressive in onto Leslau, as they'll be able to take this. Verifier isn't going to save him. Liquid's aggression gets them the first blood here with his tri-lane. Yeah, I'd be surprised if he skips it. He's mid. Trying to go on to Quinn quick, but he's actually able to get
it. What was that range?
I was going to say the range of that last instance of damage. I was surprised that hit him, but it did. I mean, sure, he goes down, but he got himself that solo kill. We'll see the dive in. The Remnant actually catching back Boxy. Boxy will still get the kill, but he's taking tower hits. SVG should be able to find him in return, and he does. So 2 for 2 in the mid.
There to just soak up the experience. Quincy trying to invade.
Quinn, he's able to get the jump straight in onto Mikke. Mikke trying to run, but they'll take him down and quickly move over to Insania. They get the two of them.
Usually when Team Liquid tries to kill the stacks is between 7 and 8 minute mark. They had a good read. They see Sven missing out from the lane. Roll.
I mean, Boxy's tried to come across to stop them from taking the stacks. Tiger is heading over. Boxy rather low. Tiger not quite able to close the gap and get in for a black hole potential as Juwar turns with a quick dagger, takes out Boxy. But do continue to push them away. Lower will fall. Sit down bottom. Quaifa trying to get aggressive onto Leslau. Leslau gets the ult off. Polisson's just in time with the roll to stop Leslau from going down. And they're going to be able to turn and take out Quaifa. At the same time, Loa finishes off Tiger.
A lot of the time, meanwhile, they're trying to set up some vision and also de-warding.
Polisson should die for this one. That was in a little too close for comfort against Mikke. Top lane, Liquid now making some good moves themselves. You know, they take down one and they do manage to turn it into two more kills onto both Polisson and Leslau on the top lane.
Because they were fighting near the Roche pit, but the Team Liquid will take the fight. Smoked Enigma with the Blink Dagger and the Black Hole available.
Let's see if they can burst lower. They're onto him, but again, the Ghost set for the Siphon. Loa's able to heal himself back up. Quinn jumps against the Silence. Tiger's looking for an angle to get in on this. The Freezing Field's out from Insania.
Mikke dropping very low.
You see Juwar very hesitant as well to jump in. He's waiting for that Black Hole, but now the Malefist, they're stepping in over towards the PA. Stone pull across as well for Boxy. They punch up, they're taking him down. They'll bring down Juwar, but both Mikke, Quaifa, and Insania incredibly low. They've got to run. It's Quaifa desperately trying to retreat, but Polisson's chasing in. There'll be a buyback from Insania. It's Polisson, rolls over. Mikke able to turn with the stun. See if they can do anything to bail Polisson out of this. He tries to slide away with a four staff, but they'll get him. It's Liquid, they'll get the kills, and they'll manage to force Quincy crew back out of the pit.
They can potentially burst him. There is this save coming up from the Tusk, much easier to execute with the Blink Dagger.
So he's going to get the jump first, but trying to go for Loa. Jump over the shards, boxes in with the snowball. Loa keeping himself alive with the Ghost Scepter. Do Quincy crew want to take this fight, or do they want to back off? Looks like they're going to let him be. They're going to leave the DP alone over to the side. Going in for Quinn,
available.
But a good force from Polisson shoves Quinn over to the side. Big crit comes out with the dagger to bring Mikke down low. Still chasing. Mikke, he really Yoles. Wants to finish Quinn. He's going pretty deep in for this one. Can he get it? He can. Will manage to take down Quinn on the Void Spirit. Top lane. Quaifa with the control onto Leslau. Buying time for further TPs to come in, but the BKB is up.
Punch.
He's over the TP up. Boxy, he's in with the uppercut. Smashes him up. Leslau's going to go for a second attempt at the TP. They haven't got the damage.
10, 15 minutes? Not really, huh?
It's been a bit of a slower one. Might see something kick off here, Boxy. But the jump onto Loa, not enough to get him. Loa's going to be able to live, but Quint's coming in with the turnaround, jumps in with the dissimulate, takes down Boxy. And we'll lose Loa. On the side, Leslau getting caught in the Midnight Pulse. He'll put the BKB, try and run. Mikke staying on top of him. And we'll manage to finish off the Prophet. As Leslau falls, the buyback comes out from Boxy. Liquid are going to try and turn this into more. As they're on top of Polisson. Polisson attempts to roll away, but Mikke blocks him off.
One good thing about Sven is that you can upgrade your Blink Dagger now. That's pretty big, especially if you decide to go for the Swift Blink.
So they'll have a bit of a window if they want to go for that before Leslau's back up. They'll try and make it even more certain that they can get away with Roche by trying to find a kill before they attempt for it lower. He has been found. Snowball's going to be heading over. Is there anything they could do to save him? He's going to be forced down to the side.
Polis still alive.
Is able to get him back to safety, and now they're falling a little low here, Liquid. Ryoa, he's good to go. He's going to head straight over Tiger. He's looking for the position, but he's not able to find it. Mickey turns, takes out Polis and Ryoa with a crit. Removes Insanity from the game. Jumps over the
crit,
and there's the black hole from the high ground. Tiger locks down the two of them. They can't take the fight here, Quincy Crew. As Mickey's low, Aloha falls. Only Lesnar left alive, and he can't get in on this. Oh, Quincy Crew prepared for this. They're actually going to put the God Strength and just go for Roshan themselves. Look to finish it. And they're taking it down very quickly.
Steal the cheese with the courier.
It's going to have to be a big commitment here for Quincy Crew if they want to try and slow this down. Already over to the side. The Ghost Scepter taken off by the stun on Mickey, but Mickey's getting bashed by Roche. It'll hold him back momentarily. The God Strength with the BKB is only going to last so long. He's going to turn towards Polison, but now the BKB's come to an end for Mickey. Liquid have been forced up to the high ground, and Roshan's so low. They're going to look to finish it off. Ywar steps in. They're going to be able to get it themselves.
Tiger's ready to jump in.
Cheese and Roche. It's all Quincy Crews. Help siege the buildings. We're going to have the smoke from Quincy Crew. See who they can find. See who they can catch. Quinn, he's ready to make the jump straight over towards Mickey. Mickey having to put the BKB to get out. Ywar, he's going to commit deep. He's going straight over towards Insania. Tiger's watching from the side. Ywar's falling very, very low here. He's able to jump back over towards the side. They'll take him down once. It's going to be the Aegis gone. Over the back lines, Quince trying to keep a hold on to Tiger. But Tiger moves in with the BKB, the Black Hole locked down. Didn't catch Ywar. Ywar's able to step out to the side. He can wait it out, and he can look to get back in. Jumps over towards Mickey. Mickey's down and out with that Moonshot purchase. He's got no buyback. He's out for 100. As Quincy Crew, they're ready to move on for more. Lower and Polison both
everyone
incredible.
Is so low.
But Foxy can't finish them off on his own. He's got to run. He's up to the high ground. He may just live himself.
Wait,
able
did
to
they
flicker
just,
away.
Did you just force him on the high ground?
I believe it was a sort of a mercy force from Polison.
Okay, but that was a good fight. Like, if Phantom Assassin is caught there, I think Phantom Assassin died. They focused her down, but unfortunately, it was not enough. As you said, Sven does not have a buyback, so they're going to go in. A lot of minus armor coming up from the Deso, coming up from the AC.
No tier 2s up on the side lane. Still 50 seconds without Mickey.
Bottom lane, 40 seconds. Those barracks are going down so quickly with the minus armor.
Huge amounts of pressure here. They're getting so much Quincy Crew off the back of that fight as everything has begun to really crumble. After a game that Liquid, they were holding on, they were keeping it even. But one explosive fight, and certainly Quincy Crew, they've taken two racks and they're starting to threaten the third. Still 15 seconds, no Mickey.
And they need to do something because they are going to play against the Mega Creeps.
See the BKB out from Ywar.
Just focus the barracks, 5 seconds without Mickey. They can take it. They have enough time. There it is.
They've got it. They don't even mind if they lose some heroes here. They'll happily die. Ywar will happily take a break. As he'll fall, lower also goes down, but they got what they wanted. Mega Creeps are out against Liquid. Obviously, Liquid, they really want to try and force that out of them. See if they're able to put up enough pressure against the three remaining survivors of Quincy Crew to sort of get Ywar.
And no need to use a buyback.
You think they can hold it off there easily?
Yeah, I think they just trade one side. We'll see how it goes, you know. Maybe if they have a glyph, okay, so there's going to be a couple of extra seconds. Ywar also has that nullifier against Ghost Scepter, which is really nice. They also have a Force Staff and another Ghost Scepter. So they can just buy time. No need for Phantom Assassin to buy back. Even if they lose one side, it's all good. Treants in the base, so that's going to be a lot of damage. Cheese Aegis plus something. We're going to see in 25 seconds. Smoke from Liquid.
Get the jump in, Poxy. It's up to the high ground. They're going to be able to kick Poxy over towards the side. Policy is getting focused. Can he actually get out of this one? He's still alive somehow. Finally falls. They have the magical nuke to take him out. An instant buyback from Polison as he wants to get back in this and get ready to punish them as the Godstroke comes to an end. They're committing onto lower. The Cypher's not enough to keep him alive as he will go down. Boxy has got to be careful. He's
Mickey,
on the front line.
HP.
Dagger's coming in. The Ghost Scepter will protect Boxy from the hits of the PA. Quinn diving in over towards the Tusk. Boxy able to flicker away. He's still on the retreat, but Ywar's chasing at the same time. The base is going down. The tier 4s are falling. Liquid, they've got too much to deal with, and I don't think they can.
Double buyback.
Out the buybacks, but Ywar, he's in onto Quaifa. Quaifa down. Mickey turns with the stun onto Polison.
Oh, that's a dieback from
the
him.
Earth Spirit.
But it also, Loa bought back. He can't afford to die.
I think they're going to be able to take him. He's been caught in the base.
Oh, they just wanted too much. I think they just needed to slow it down a bit because Leslau was sending Treants in the enemy base. There is still one tier 4 tower left, keeping themselves alive or just using it. And there it is.
Oh,
and this is what we want to see. Divine Rapier. Oh, that's going to be quite a lot of damage. Quincy Crew, meanwhile, in the Roche Pit. She's Aegis plus Aghanim Scepter.
Who's taking the axe?
Ah, you give it to BA. Got buyback.
Do they got a DD as well? DD, God Strength, Divine Rapier.
They're going to go for tier 4s.
They could look to
just
end it.
What's that damage? Let's check it out.
There we have it, Mikkei.
Almost 1,300.
Trying to bring him down a little bit before he starts to go for the push, before he goes for the siege. The base, Quaifa's having to deal with it. And the Greater Treants are beating down. Oh, you are! They've just found the jump on him. That's the Aegis gone. Can they go for a second round? Tiger's trying to get in position from the side. Tiger comes in with the black hole.
That's the black hole.
He locks it down. Yawar's out.
Has buyback, but the Ancient, they never forced to use a glyph on Liquid. This is pretty big.
They get the catch on Leslau. Leslau going for the BKB TP out. He's not making it out of there. Mikkei has the damage.
Oh, this is a close one. Like, this game, what Team Liquid needs is Kael Phantom Assassin.
It's time to wake up. We're going to get an exciting siege here shortly by Liquid. Liquid.
20 seconds for Phantom Assassin, 30 seconds for Nacious Prophet.
Oh, Quinn. He's in and he's
just
out.
Buying
he's in.
Time.
He's in and he's in. He's staying in. He can't get out.
Cheese is available.
Quinn,
he can't get it.
All right, he's going to have to buy back here. The tier 4 is getting taken down by Liquid. Quinn ready for round 2. It's Liquid. Step back.
That's
for now.
A refresher on Enigma. Taiga is ready to go. No black hole.
That's Liquid. They're actually heading straight over here now that they know the Quincy crew's around this spot. CCNC's got to be careful. Quim, pull back. And Jawar. I mean, he's looking pretty dead. The big Phantom Strike over towards Quinn. He's trying to run, but Mikkei's charging him down. Jawar's
another blink strike.
Turn back in, jumps back out. Over towards Quinn. The snowball's there, though, and Jawar forced to the side.
Blink.
And they save him. They can't. Jawar goes down.
Three times in a row would be just a bit too much.
Yeah, pretty wild, wildly small difference to see in a
double
game where
damage
creeps
spawned
around.
On the bottom. It's being pinged out. I believe that's Brown's ping. Taiga.
Let's now. He's got the hex opening. They're trying to go in onto Quaifa. They've got him. That's Quaifa down for 2 minutes. Mikkei. He's going to try for Lesnar in return. Pollison rolls over, slides himself back out. The snowball over towards Lesnar.
Mikkei's stuck.
Comes in from Boxy. Mikkei, he's trapped. He's trapped in the trees. The Remnants does pull him out to the side, but the single Remnants good to go. Quinn continues to play around with him. The level 25 to simulate stun. Holds him back once more, given the time for Quinn to jump out with a step.
We're getting close to tier 5 items. 2 minutes.
Was going to start going for Roche. I don't think it looks like Liquid's going to be in a position to deal with it. They're dropping the black hole onto Quinn, but I don't know if this was the plan, but it seems like it's a bit of a bait. Take their attention away from this
he
area.
He does not have buyback for another 5 seconds, and he also does not have enough money for the buyback.
Boxy tries to get in to put a stop to it, but they've got the hex. So that's the trade that will be taken there by Quincy. They give up Quinn's life for the space required to get this Roche. It is that Aghanim's on the refresher shard. That's Mikkei. He's the jump in onto the two of them. Pollison. He's going to be able to turn with a disarm.
He has the disc. If he hits him one more time, there's the disc proc.
He's going to struggle getting away from this. There are a lot of stuns coming out. So Pollison also gone. Also, the courier actually left it inside the pit. The item that's the most annoying to deal with has to be that mirror shield.
Oh, yeah. Mirror shield is just, I think it's that's the best in the Ex Machina in certain situations, on certain heroes. Depends which items you have.
Top line, Mikkei. Get the hex. Yawar's in, but Taiga's going to have the counterplay. Comes in with a black hole to lock him down. They have the damage to bring down Yawar the once. They do. Yawar's gone once, but the damage for Lesnar is enough that he just pummels into Taiga. Taiga falls. Mikkei's got to run. There's going to be a buyback coming out from Taiga. Liquid, they've still got the three of them. They're going to jump back in
available.
Open towards lower. That's the first Eon Disc proc. We'll see if he wants to use the refresher to have a second round.
Might need to use it.
Dagger's coming out from the sidelines. So Yawar gets the damage going. The Cypher doing a lot to Mikkei here, tearing through that strength. Lower will still go down, though. As they're the rest of them, they're ready to go back in. Yawar, he's going to jump in, gets the
Insania
crit off.
Deleted.
Insania's gone. Yawar jumps over towards the creep, trying to kite out Mikkei. Mikkei's God Strength is shortly going to be coming to an end. Leslau's in, beats down Quaifa. Quaifa's out of the game. He's got a buyback of anyone target. The single black hole is in. He's got the three of them. Mikkei, it does. He's got the damage. The PA goes down. Taiga with the black holes holding on for this game. as they've got a chance here. They're continuing to stay in the action, Liquid, thanks to the power of Tiger.
All the buybacks, only one who bought back pretty much is Tiger. Like, something happened. Problem is, Mickey, he still has buyback.
See the jump. Boxy, there with a protector. Mickey's going to come across the end. Disc is going to be able to get Quinn out of there. Disarm onto Mickey. Mickey's got to be careful. As he's used this, it's through why he jumps over to the back line. Boxy's gone down. Boxy buys
in
back
and out
immediately. BKB's starting to come to an end for your wise. Off into the shadows with the blur. He'll get away. Pressure continuing to build up against Liquid with the creeps. The tree, it's pushing in over towards the Ancient. Quinn over towards Mickey and Senya. Falling low, Ghost stepped up in a few seconds. The Book of the Dead's out, the pressure really building up. Mickey able to take down Polison. The Book of the Dead is onto the Ancient. They're just trying to beat it down here with the summon,
Mickey.
But Mickey can deal with it with the cleave. But they turn, they've got the Hex.
They're going to take him down.
They're going to have the damage. They do. They take down Mickey. Buyback immediately from the Sven. Tusk snowballs over towards the Nation's Prophet. They've got
no
the
one
damage.
Has buyback.
Lower. Lower goes down. Polison's out as well. Leslo's out. Three dead on Quincy Crew. No buyback.
Liquid might be doing it. No heroes with the buyback. 120 seconds.
Liquid, he's got to
70
try and put
seconds. I just don't think there's enough time. And Taiga, he has two black holes.
He does. It's Quinn trying to do his best to just slow them down with the disables, with the stuns. You are spamming out those daggers, but a tier falls down.
Now Liquid. This is it. Liquid are doing it.
They certainly are by the looks of it. The second tower is going to go. Ancient is exposed. Mickey trying to close it. Quinn, he's got to do something now. They'll jump over Yuwa's in, but he's got to watch out for Tiger. Tiger stands
There's
up.
There's the black
the
hole.
The black hole's there. Yuwa's gone. Liquid, they'll be able to close up the game.
Nothing they can do anymore.
And this time around, Quincy Crew, they're going to get to show us what they can do with it.
Liquid Ward, where they set up a deep observer ward in the enemy triangle on the high ground to see what's going on, any kind of rotation, if there are any stacks being made so they can come in and steal it. Daiga, that's going to be the first blood.
So they are coming in. Quinn, up to the bear. He's going to be able to turn his attention over towards Quaikfa. Quaikfa's in trouble. He's going to get taken out. Loa's coming over for the side.
But here comes Boxy.
It's burst through. Loa's while taking huge amounts of damage from Mickey. Mickey's able to just stand in the center of it all.
Guy.
And the Midas Battle Fury, you know, go the whole way. It's Midas into Maelstrom over the build up for Yuwa. So top lane. They go, Polison and Quinn. Now try for Boxy. False Promise comes out from Insania. Boxy. See if he's going to have enough heals from the regeneration.
Yeah, he's good.
He also has
a healing cell.
Oh, yeah, he's
that
back
Insania
up to
pop.
See them run down here. Omni Slash from Yuwa. We'll make quick work of the two of them. Mickey's gone. See if Quaikfa can turn this around as he's trying to keep the bear on them, but Quincy Crew, they're running them down. Liquid's got to get out of it. The bear caught out by the stun. Quaikfa trying to get it back to safety. The fear will send them back, but Quinn's able to finish it off.
Let's see the positioning. Taiga trying to break the smoke. Nicely done.
See if Loa can get the jump. Already straight away. The silence is out under the fourth, and they turn their BAO to take down the Enigma before Loa can do anything. There's going to be no threat of the black hole for this fight, as the rest of Quincy Crew have to back off. Polison caught out by Mickey with the combo. Liquid, they find the two of them. Quincy Crew walking into a bit of a disaster there. See what Quincy Crew's plan's going to be. I mean, in the mid, they've caught out. Yuwa, can they take him down? Yuwa, he's trying to run. They've got him. The damage is there, and he's out for 50. No buyback, so a little bit of an early window for them to maybe push in. They're going to start moving out over towards Mickey. Great
silence.
Insania, but he's still got a bit of time to buy himself with the yules. False Promise comes out. Insania's able to get it off before he goes down.
Good body block
committing
from
onto Mickey with the static link. There's now from the back with the exorcism. He's cleaning up the back lines. He's taken down Boxy. Boxy's gone. Mickey's down the once. See Quaikfa with the bear starting to charge in over towards Quinn, but they're able to kite out the bear, turn around, take it out. The bear will fall. Now Quaikfa's in trouble. The shard's actually pushing him up
on
to the
high ground.
He says, thank you, Polison. And Yuwa making the best he can of the space that's being given. Top lane, he's going to bring it all the way around to the tier 3 of Liquid. Whilst at the same time, the rest of his team's going to hold on with the defense. Start to make the moves onto Mickey. Safety comes out from Insania. Bring him that magic immunity, and now Mickey maybe thinking about turning.
They're
back
going
the
bear.
Down to the ball. They head over to the bear, but Polison has been stunned. The root's out. Mickey's in with the damage. They take down Polison. Quinn commits with the BKB. Trying to stay on top of Mickey. Turns his attention over towards Boxy. He's following down the Timbersaw into the trees. Mikkei saved at the last moment by the False Promise. He left the Bloodstone heal as well, but it's a lot of damage coming out for Quincy Crew.
There's also healing cell, but the Spirit Vessel, yeah, it will keep him alive.
He's able to turn, get the connection onto Quinn, but Quinn's too speedy, but the boost of travel, he's out to the side. Now Leslau staying on top of Mikkei. Mikkei tries to DP out, but the damage is too much.
Mikkei.
He's going to head over. He's going for the ult setup, but the silence comes in from Leslau.
Oh, good Lotus.
Oh, the Lotus was there just in time to put a stop to the slashes from Yawar. Yawar will still be able to turn, take down Tiger with the Blade Fury. And Quincy Crew, they're still ready to chase down. The False Promise being used on Quite for Insania, getting taken out by the siphons of Leslau. And Lotus in!
There's
he's
the black
the black hole. He's caught. Mikkei is caught. Quite for gets the two cores. Mikkei goes down. The exorcism from Leslau just tearing them apart. Too much damage here from the DP!
And they can just go inside a pit and take it. Healing ward not available, but he definitely deserves a tip. So far, pretty much having a perfect game. Like, the itemization is a bit different. A good black hole coming out from position 5 Enigma. Has that blink dagger. A bit unfortunate, you know, that Lotus Orb came in very handy and very quick. I think Juggernaut needs to be a bit more aware of that and not try to go for the Omni Slash straight away, possibly. I don't think there's any downside of that item, except the cost.
Mikkei, he tries to go in on to Leslau, but Leslau's able to just instantly get the BKB off. And now once again, Quincy Crew, they're more than happy to take the fight. Yawar jumps in with the Sasha, they're taken out. Mikkei, they're taken out. Tiger, they're taken out. Insania.
Oh, Yawar, nicely done. Just they defend Boxy. The barracks, box is in.
Trying
spin.
To take away that Aegis, but Blade Fury's up. Yawar, he'll TP away. He's out safe.
They're not going to be able to get anyone. Boxy, Yule Scepter ready, might get Floa. Okay, they got him. At least it's something. Good Bloxy. Nicely done.
It's Boxy. Let me see if he can get a catch here with the Yules, but Quincy Crew, it's a little too quick there to keep the distance. Quincy Crew, they have the high ground. And Liquid really want to try and fight into this. It's hard. Quincy Crew have the ward down. They've got good vision. Yawar, he's going to be able to jump over straight away as Tiger just offers up his life. He goes immediately in. Leslau, he's already running down the rest of Liquid.
Yeah, Leslau is like, I don't give a damn. I'm going in.
He just charges straight at the rest of the team, and they're having to run. They cannot stand anywhere near the DP whilst the exorcism's out. Even trying to pop a smoke to get the extra movement speed to get out of there. Quinn, he's in with the BKB, gets the static link off, but the Lotus was there.
Yeah, the double suck, static link, plus spirit siphon is just too much on the bear.
A clutch false promise comes out just in time on a Quaifa. The black hole put to an end immediately by the silence of Tiger. Quaifa's getting low. They've got enough heals to keep him alive, though. Leslau, he's just permanently at full HP. And Yawar has the time to take them down, the three of them over the Boxy. Boxy will TP away. That's four down, and they do not have buybacks.
Healing ward not available. Boxy needs to be careful.
He's got to pull off some insane defense here on his own. A Quincy Crew, they're not falling for it. They're ignoring Boxy. They're looking to close it. They know that Boxy's doing this desperation play because they don't have buybacks. And now Yawar, he's able to turn onto Boxy. They have the control. Boxy, by some time with the ults, he'll have the Lotus back up in a second. Is on in time before the slash comes out. As Boxy will live, but Quinn, he's had enough. He's ignoring him. He's closing it up. He's going for the tier 4.
20 seconds. No, that's all they need, but I feel Quincy Crew, they have enough time. Boxy cannot hold this one alone.
He absolutely can't. He's trying his best, but they'll just ignore him.
Sometimes
Boxy,
your best is not enough. He's like, come on, hit me.
But no mercy from Quincy Crew. They see the victory.